much because you love me, Celine Dion. Thanks for listening. Sarah Cox after Mike with the news. I'm back tomorrow at 4 p.m. This is BBC Radio 2.
BBC News at 5 o'clock. This is Mike Powell. King Charles has been greeted by cheering crowds outside Buckingham Palace. He's preparing to address the nation as monarch for the first time. Liz Truss has led tributes to Queen Elizabeth in the Commons. King Charles III has been greeted by cheering well-wishers on his arrival at Buckingham Palace. He's held his first audience with the Prime Minister, Liz Truss, and will make his first address to the nation as king in about an hour's time. He had flown from Aberdeen following the death yesterday of his mother, Queen Elizabeth II. Our home editor, Mark Easton, is near the palace and sent this report.
It was a very deliberate statement. In his first public act as king, Charles ordered his car to stop outside the gates of Buckingham Palace, on the public side of the black railings, and went to greet his people alone. Working a crowd is second nature to Charles, but this was a monarch demonstrating that he intends to be approachable. He shook hundreds of hands, chatting and smiling. One woman kissed his wrist, another kissed his cheek. Charles did not seem in the least disconcerted. The king, it seems, wanted nothing to get between him and the people he now rules. Their response? A spontaneous chorus of God Save the King.
Earlier, church bells rang out and guns were fired at places across the UK to mark the Queen's death. Thousands of people are continuing to leave flowers outside royal residences in her memory. Michael and Alison travelled from Kent to Windsor Castle.
We wanted to show our respects after hearing the unfortunate news of the Queen, and we wanted to come and have a look at the flowers and say a few prayers.
It feels strange because with so many people here, it's quite quiet, it's very quiet, and it's just sort of like, it's lovely to see sort of like everybody coming together to show their respects, really.
MPs have been paying their respects to Queen Elizabeth in a special sitting of the House of Commons. They packed the chamber dressed in black as a minute's silence was observed. Leading the tributes, the Prime Minister, Liz Truss, said it was a huge moment for the country.
On the death of her father, King George VI, Winston Churchill said the news had stilled the clatter and traffic of 20th century life in many lands. Now, 70 years later, in the tumult of the 21st century, life has paused again. Her late Majesty, Queen Elizabeth II, was one of the greatest leaders the world has ever known.
The Labour leader, Sir Keir Starmer, praised the Queen's commitment to service.
Queen Elizabeth created a special personal relationship with us all. That relationship was built on the attributes that defined her reign. Her total commitment to service and duty, her deep devotion to the country, the Commonwealth, and the people she loved.
The former Prime Minister, Theresa May, shared a fond memory. She had been asked to bring some cheese to a picnic with Queen Elizabeth, but the cheese rolled off the table and onto the floor.
I picked up the cheese, put it on the plate, and put it on the table. I turned round to see that my every move had been watched very carefully by Her Majesty the Queen. I looked at her, she looked at me, and she just smiled. And the cheese remained on the table.
All of the weekend's football matches have been postponed as a mark of respect. Play in the third test between England and South Africa was suspended today but will resume tomorrow. In other news, police investigating the death of 9-year-old Olivia Pratt-Corbell in Liverpool have made another arrest. An 18-year-old man was taken into custody last night on suspicion of assisting an offender. He's the 10th person to be detained by detectives investigating the case. A man's been arrested in connection with the bomb attack by the IRA in Manchester city centre in 1996. The blast caused extensive damage and injured more than 200 people. No one was ever charged. Police say they've been pursuing new lines of inquiry after reviewing the original case files. In the city, the 100 share index has closed up 89 points at 7,351. The weather...